Hello and welcome to this course on business statistics for decision making. In this first lecture, we will take an introduction to statistics. The learning objective for this lecture is to understand what is statistics. After completing this lecture, you should be able to better visualize applications of statistics in business management. Let's start this lecture with the story of Michael. Michael is a young man aspiring to be a successful management professional. To fulfill his dreams, he enrolled into a leading management school. Michael loved the exposure he was gaining until he encountered statistics. Statistics made him paranoid.
Stats is a complex bunch of numbers, formula, and graphs that I can't comprehend.
In the meantime, Mary, the experienced statistics teacher, enters the classroom.
Stats is a monster. And that's the one we will tame today. Please tell me. Before enrolling to this management school, did you search and evaluate various other alternative institutions? And did you roughly rank them based on certain criteria, like fees, placements, and faculty? Very well then. You know a lot of stats, you have already used it in good amount.
Michael is beginning to feel excited now. So let's commence our lecture by looking at what is statistics. Statistics can be referred to as the art and science of collecting, analyzing, presenting, and interpreting data. The term statistics can refer to numerical facts, such as medians, averages, percentages, and index numbers, that help us understand a variety of business and economic situations. We must appreciate that stats is not just a subject in itself, it's a great tool that assists managers in all fields. For instance, in accounting, public accounting firms use statistical sampling procedures when conducting audits for their clients. Economics. Economists use statistical information in making forecasts about the future of the economy or aspects of the economy. Finance. Financial advisors use price-earnings ratios and dividend yields to guide their investment advice. Marketing. Electronic point-of-sale scanners at retail checkout counters are used to collect data for a variety of marketing research applications. Production. A variety of statistical quality control charts are used to monitor the output of a production process. Information systems. Statistical information helps administrators assess the performance of computer networks. Do you see anything in common in all these examples? It's all about collecting and analyzing data using data sets. So what is data? Data are the facts and figures collected, analyzed, and summarized for presentation and interpretation. And a data set is the categorization of data collected for a particular study. Now, a big question here is, how is data used in stats? The first step is arranging data so that it is comparable. When arranging data, we have three terms: elements, variables, and observations. Consider a table displaying details about candidates applying for management school admission. Don't worry about the data, just visualize the table. If we visualize it like a table, then elements are the entities on which data are collected. It is the name of the row. For example, if we are collecting data about candidates, then the name of the candidates are elements. A variable is a characteristic of interest for the elements. It is the name of the column. So if we are collecting data about candidates, then country of residence, interview performance, SAT score, and credits earned can all be variables. An observation is the set of measurements obtained for a particular element. It is one row. So information collected across all variables for a particular candidate would become an observation. The table itself is the dataset. If there are no elements, then it will have no observations. Each cell is called a data value, and its number in a dataset would be the number of elements multiplied by the number of variables. With this, we end our discussion on first lecture. Thanks for watching.